Hey guys, it's me, Izzyhedron, and today I'm showing you two Desmos projects related to graphing in four dimensions that I made. I should mention that this is not graphing per se, but more like the displaying and projection of lines in four-dimensional space that make up the illusion of a shape. And I should also say that I'm not hugely educated on these things, so if you have any clarifications to make, don't hesitate to put them in the comments. With that said, let's begin. The first one of these projects displays a shape in four-dimensional space and projects it to the two-dimensional graph. Here we can see lines in all four directions, the x direction, the y direction, the z direction, and the w direction. If this seems odd, we do this for 3D all the time. In this cube, here's the x direction, the y direction, and the z direction. We can also rotate our new friend along its six axes of rotation with these buttons. Why are there six axes of rotation? Coming soon in a future video. This is a tesseract, or an 8-cell by the way, and it's my favorite 4D shape. It's the 4D equivalent of a cube. How does that make sense? Coming soon in a future video. I was also able to make a 5-cell, the equivalent of the tetrahedron. The only other 4D shape I was able to make was a 16-cell, the equivalent of an octahedron. It was a bit time-consuming due to the way I coded it in, and I would be interested to know if there are other ways to do it. So why are they called something cells? Well, just like how a face is a piece of the surface of a 3D shape, a cell is the piece of the surface of the 4D shape. Faces are two-dimensional, and cells are three-dimensional. The 4D object shown here, a 5-cell, has 5 tetrahedrons inside it. In this animation, you can have a look at the 8 cubes inside an 8-cell. I encourage you to get acquainted with 4D shapes a little more, because there's a lot of interesting stuff here. We can also do a quote-unquote shadow projection of a 4D shape. Here's one of a tesseract which you might recognize. Here in the shadow projection, the first three axes, x, y, and z, are projected like they would normally be for 3D graphing, but the w axis is represented with how far a point is from the center. The higher a point's w value is, the further it will be from the center. The center, shown here, is at w equals negative infinity. When we rotate the tesseract, it looks pretty cool. The other one of these two projects I wanted to show you today is one that shows 3D slices, or cross-sections, of 4D shapes. So first, to get you acquainted with the interface, let's take 2D slices of 3D shapes. The A variable denotes what cross-section we're on. So here we're taking cross-sections of a cube. It's a square. Wow. To show us what's going on, I made a little Desmos graph. Notice how the A variable dictates what cross-section we're on. We can also rotate the shapes before taking slices of them. Do you recognize this shape? This shows us what's really going on. We can see how the rectangular varying width fits into the cube. So, yep, that was the cube on its edge. Now here's the cube on its corner. It's a triangle that turns into a hexagon that then turns into an opposite triangle. This animation shows us what's actually going on. Alright, so now let's take 3D slices of 4D shapes. This time, the slices are 3D instead of 2D. When we take slices of an unrotated tesseract, we get a cube that blinks in and out of existence. What if we tilt the tesseract? Let's put it on its edge. Well, that's certainly very interesting, but you can see how it relates to when we put a cube on its edge in our 3D analog. What if we put the tesseract in its corner? It's a tetrahedron that grows in size until it becomes an octahedron at the very center, then turns into the opposite tetrahedron, then shrinks to nothingness. This relates to the cube that was put on its corner. Ain't that cool? I find these loose cross-dimensional analogs very interesting. For fun, let's also do a random rotation. It seems to me that at least the majority of these orientations result in this kind of thing, with cubes growing and then getting devoured. What happens if we rotate a tesseract while we're taking a cross-section of it? Wowee, don't math and drive. That's it for the showcase of the two Desmos projects. Both of these projects were made during I guess what you could call my Desmos phase about a year ago. I've been procrastinating on an explanation video for a very long time. I figured that the release of Desmos 3D about a month ago was a sign that I should get going with the showcase video before it's too late, so that's what this is here. I encourage you to keep exploring this topic, and so I'll have some recommendations in the description. Also, try to figure out how to do this Desmos stuff on your own. Start with 3D graphing, and then generalize what you made. I'll give you a hint to think about rotations in terms of planes, not axes, and to process each rotation variable in their own function. I hope you have fun! Since you made it to the end of the video, I'll show you some bonus animations from my self-described Desmos phase.